PPE must be put on correctly and in the sequence outlined in this film. It is based on the buddy system and relies on an independent verifier to ensure PPE is worn correctly. The buddy must read aloud the stages in the sequence, tick off each stage, and be satisfied that the PPE is worn correctly. No modification is to be made to the PPE in the patient care area. During patient care, regular observations and checking between pairs is essential in maintaining the PPE integrity. Before putting on your PPE, you need to ensure you are wearing theatre scrubs and regular footwear. Take your time at all stages of this process to ensure you follow the correct procedures. Do not rush. Putting on protective footwear. Sit down on a firm, stable, and cleanable seat. Apply the protective footwear 1 foot at a time, using the ankle elastic, and pull over the heel and up the trouser leg. Use the seam as a guide to ensure the correct placement on your feet. The seam should be at the center of your foot. Inner gloves. You should only use nitrile gloves. These should be put on one at a time. If you experience any breaches in your inner gloves, remove and start again. Hood. If you wear spectacles, remove these before donning the hood. Don the hood with the V-shape at the front. Once the hood has been fitted, replace your spectacles if worn. Gown. Your buddy is required to help fit your fluid repellent gown. Put both arms in the sleeves and wear the gown over your inner gloves. Your buddy will then ensure your gown is securely tied at the back. Apron. Again, with assistance from your buddy, hook the apron over your head and place your arms in the long sleeves. Your buddy will then tie your apron at the rear. Ensure you use a long sleeve thumb looped apron and use the thumb loops as demonstrated. Mask. Use a high filter FFP3 mask. All staff need to be properly fit tested. Place the mask over your head. Your buddy needs to ensure that the straps of the mask are in this position. One strap at the top of your head and one around the neck at the bottom of your head. Your buddy also needs to ensure that the mask is properly fitted and there is a good seal in place with no exposed skin around the neck. Adjust the mask as required. Visor or goggles. Place your visor or goggles over your head with the strap at the top. Your buddy should ensure that the visor is in this position, past the line of the hood and below the line of the face mask, to ensure that no skin is exposed. Outer gloves. Your outer gloves should also be nitrile, and these need to be pulled over the sleeves of your apron and your gown. If you have any breaches in your outer gloves, replace them. If during patient care, a partial or total breach in PPE occurs, you must immediately remove yourself to the PPE removal area to assess the level of risk that exposure has caused. Derobing also requires strict observance to the removal sequence, and the buddy must read aloud the stages and tick off each stage to be satisfied that it's removed safely and correctly. The buddy is there to assist and observe derobing as necessary. The buddy should move to a safe distance when not required. The buddy requires PPE, a long-sleeved thumb-looped apron, gloves, a visor or goggles, and mask. Outer gloves. Remove the outer gloves first. The outside of the glove will be contaminated. Grasp the outside of the glove, dirty to dirty, with the opposite gloved hand. Hold the removed glove in the gloved hand. Slide the finger of your clean gloved hand into the inside of the glove, clean to clean. Peel the gloves off so that they are turned inside out, and dispose of as clinical waste in a yellow bag. Apron. Using disposable scissors, get your buddy to cut open the rear of the apron at the neck using the non-touch technique. Leaning slightly forward, you need to peel the apron forward, keeping the contaminated area away from you. Turn the apron inside out and wrap the apron so that the dirty side is now on the inside. Dispose of the apron as clinical waste in a yellow bag. Gown. Your buddy will need to assist you in the removal of the gown. Lean slightly forward and pull the gown away from your body and turn it inside out. Wrap the gown so that the dirty side is now on the inside. Dispose of the gown as clinical waste in a yellow bag. Visor or goggles. Grasp the visor strap and pull forward. Lean forward and hold the visor or goggle strap carefully and pull away from the face. Dispose of the visor or goggles as clinical waste in a yellow bag. Mask. Leaning forward, grasp both of the mask straps and pull forward. Hold the mask strap carefully and pull the mask away from the face. Dispose of the mask or goggles as clinical waste in a yellow bag. After removing the visor or goggles and the mask, resist the urge to touch your face or scratch your nose. Hood. Grasp the hood at the V at the front of the mask. Gently pull outwards to split the hood. Collect the surplus material and carefully peel the hood off. Wrap the hood so that the dirty side is now on the inside. Leaning slightly forward, remove the hood and dispose of it as clinical waste in a yellow bag. Protective footwear. Sit down on a firm, stable and cleanable seat. Grasp the protective footwear by the ankle elastic and pull over the heel, avoiding touching the trouser leg. Keep pulling the protective footwear until it has come off. Then repeat this process with the other foot. dispose of the protective footwear as clinical waste in a yellow bag. Remove the inner gloves. The outside of the glove will be contaminated. Grasp the outside of the glove, dirty to dirty, with the opposite gloved hand. Hold the removed glove in the gloved hand. Slide your finger into the inside of the glove, clean to clean. Peel the gloves off so that they are turned inside out and dispose of as clinical waste in a yellow bag. After the derobing process, wash your hands. Using soap and water, follow the 6-step technique and then apply foam sanitizer. Dry your hands thoroughly.